grievance appeal hearing, which he regrettably withdrew before it concluded. Within a week of the appeal hearing, Councillor Harry Smith and Julius, the Deputy Mayor, and I were invited to a briefing with the then Director of Social Services because we had ongoing concerns about Mr. Martin's welfare and the performance of a council contractor. Unfortunately, you, Deputy Mayor, Councillor Ellis, you were unable to attend that meeting. However, Mr. Kevin Miller explained to Councillor Smith and I that he was dealing with these issues in the most appropriate way. That briefing was most certainly not an investigation into Mr. Morton's whistleblowing concerns. However, in the report, a former officer of this council outrageously claimed that an investigation was unnecessary because the briefing had taken place. I am angry that well-paid council officers not doing their job properly used my name to try to justify their lack of action and compassion towards Mr. Morton and also, very importantly, those vulnerable service users who have been reported as being so dreadfully abused. This council has been shaken to the core by what is alleged to have happened and the way that this council has been run. Only for Mr. Morton's tenacity, who knows what more might have come to light. Mr. Morton was not supported by our HR officers, and I too feel badly let down by council officers just in order to save their own skin. We all have a responsibility to ensure that council officers are doing their job properly. However, this has to stop at the top. The role of leader of the council is an onerous one, and he or she has a responsibility to ensure that this council runs well, that the chief executive and chief officers are monitored and reminded that they are accountable.